Okay, day 156 of One Brotherhood. I just want to answer some questions for researchers to kind of direct the research. This is an overt coup. This is a shoot sarin gas at your family and shoot Stinger missiles at the helicopters and airplanes sort of thing. This is overt war. Gulen cannot affect this kind of war yet. He even says that in his own rhetoric. Don't hatch the egg before it becomes a chicken, basically, or a chick. This is the kind of war Gulen is fighting in the United States, which is covert war, which is hacking, it's wiretaps, it's putting in doped routers, it's getting top secret access, it's using the wiretapping capability to spy on your enemies, but also spy on the enemies of your friends. So if you have different people at different fusion centers and so forth, you can attack their enemies, like whistleblowers and so forth, for profit. So this is basically Steve Feinberg taking all the things that Andrew McCabe has done for the last 20 years and just commercializing it, making it McDonald's. So if the government used to do surveillance against the Soviet Union, now the government does surveillance against the current sitting president. But if you are a private company, a Fortune 500 company, you can just go through your fusion center, and then Muslim Brotherhood will do your wiretaps for you and your hacking for you. And that's why the need for secret, top secret access and White House visas for foreign nationals. And they get hacking tools with the CIA as well. So I wanted to we're going to be going to Montreal here pretty quick and talk about agro-marketing. But this whole rice thing is going to be an interesting thing, because not only is rice with those batmati bags great for putting heroin or cocaine and smuggling that, but you can also dope the rice. You can dope the rice with a virus and make people reduce their immune systems, try all kinds of different drugs using rice as a vector. So we're going to be looking at rice as a vector on that whole supply chain. We're going to be looking at the food chain as the vector for drugs, not the brokerage system and so forth for food. It's going to be the same system for drugs. Now, I'm saying everybody in the system is involved in that, but I'm just saying the same mechanisms, the same food brokerage warehouses and cold storage facilities and all those things we have already for food is going to be used for drugs. Okay, to a lesser extent, stuff that's not in the food business as well. But mangoes is a great example, oranges, any kind of fruit's a great example, bananas obviously as well, because anything that has to be cleared quickly through customs is better than something that can sit and be inspected over time. I guess that's the point I'm trying to make there. We're going to look at also all these cutouts and what they are for, so that's going to direct some of the research. Again, we're going to be moving more and more toward the food business away from these cutouts, but nanotechnology, we're going to be looking at the bio side of this nanotechnology. Imran Awan used the nanotechnology to spy on all kinds of enemies of the Clintons.